The inaugural Filipino-American Friendship Festival is kicking off tomorrow. Joining us now to discuss the event and its significance here in San Diego is the festival chairperson, Joanne Fields. Good morning, Joanne.
Good morning, Ali. Thank you for having me.
So talk a little bit about why you decided to do this festival, and of course the date is significant as well, correct?
Yes, it is. It's a teachable moment on American history. Many may not know that the Philippines was actually a territory of the United States. And on July 4th, 1946, the Treaty of Manila was signed, where we became the Republic of the Philippines. And to celebrate the signing, but to also continue a positive and great relationship with the United States, a holiday was created called the Philippine-American Friendship Day. And we are celebrating that day through a festival we're having tomorrow at the Broadway Pier.
Now, the location of the Broadway Pier, tell me a little bit about how you guys chose that location.
Yes, we know that the beautiful backdrop of the San Diego Bay is perfect for this festival, but it also sits in the middle of the largest Navy fleet in the world. San Diego has the largest Navy fleet, and many of our Filipinos, 200,000 Filipinos reside in San Diego, and they were brought here through the military. So again, that's the significance of its location.
Yeah, and I would imagine right now it's last minute trying to make sure everything's in place. Tell me a little bit about what you're really looking forward to, because the event, I mean, you're going to have a little bit of everything tomorrow.
Yes, we're going to have authentic food. We're going to have live performances from Cedrice, the finalist in the Voice. We have Samahan Performing Arts Center for our cultural dance, the Harana Band, Solid Jam. So it's going to be a great day for all. It's a free family event. We have over 40 vendors selling merchandise. A lot of our fans are looking forward to the plumeria cuttings that you can purchase there. We'll also have pabiting, which is a traditional Filipino game for the kids to participate in. So we're going to celebrate with our first Filipino mayor, Todd Gloria, our first attorney general in the United States, California Attorney General Rob Bonta. So we're excited that they will be joining us and all of San Diego to enjoy.
I mean, there's so much work, I would imagine, that has gone into this. This has got to mean a lot to you to finally have this coming to fruition.
Yes. If you think about it, the COVID-19 restrictions for special events was just lifted on June 15th. We were working with our Port Commissioner, Sandy Naranjo, and Rafael Castellanos to make sure we can have this at the port. We have signed off for the permit. So it was just a few weeks that we were able to pull this together. But we are resilient. We have a great network of supporters. And we'll see everyone. Hopefully, everyone will be able to participate with us on Saturday.
Okay, so first time ever, and it's going to be happening at Broadway Pier, of course, 11 to 4. Like you said, a little bit of everything down there, fun for the whole family, and it's free. So that is amazing. Joanne, thank you so much for joining us, and I got to wish you, did I hear that it's your birthday today?
Oh my gosh, yes it is. I made a milestone. So it just so happened it fell on my birthday weekend. So I will admit I'm turning 50 today, but I'm working per usual. But we'll celebrate tomorrow at the festival. Oh. Another meaningful thing for me is to celebrate with my family, friends, and community.
Yeah, you're throwing the biggest party.
Yes, we're going to have the largest electric slide, so every generation can partake, and SDG&E is sponsoring that portion, so it'll be a good time.
Oh my gosh, definitely be a good time. Well, I hope you have a wonderful event tomorrow. Thank you so much for getting the information out there.
Okay, thank you, Ali.
All right, happy birthday.